Oops. What a, okay. What up, guys? Eric's still here, back with the live stream. As you can see by the title, About Damn Time. About Damn Time. Ow. About damn time I get the jersey I had ordered. I had to contact them through the customer service team that they had for me to receive the jersey after mistakenly getting Pittsburgh Pirates gear. I did not order any Pirates gear. I ordered a Terry Bradshaw jersey. You know, I was going to unveil it on Mac Mainstream, but as y'all saw, it turned out to be Pirates gear instead. I guess it was supposed to be shipped to somebody else. That's my guess. Which I still have the Pirates gear here somewhere. But what I actually ordered is finally here. I already took it out of the package and everything. I mean, there's no point in doing an unveiling because y'all already know what it's going to be. I have it right here. Here it is. And here it is. Here it is right here. Number 12. Terry Bradshaw. In the back. And then there's the back of the jersey as well. Terry Bradshaw, number 12. So here it is. Let's put this bad boy on, shall we? Here it is. Here it is. So this is the jersey. Terry Bradshaw, of course, was the quarterback back in the 70s and early 80s. Won 4 Super Bowls. You know, thanks to the Steel Curtain defense, of course, with the likes of those guys right there. So there you have it, man. I finally get my... Yes, this is a medium. I finally get my Terry Bradshaw jersey, number 12. So there you have it, man. I got it. What's up? Let's see. So there you have it. Terry Bradshaw. Bam. So there you have it, man. Terry Bradshaw jersey right there. So let's see the live chat. Who's in here? What's up, Jerry? What? It is the right one, thank God. What's up, whoever this guy here is? Brandon Rogers. Yeah, thank God, right? I would have been pissed had they actually messed it up. But then again, I had already took it out of the package before I started this because, I mean, what's the point of doing it live when y'all already know what jersey it's going to be since I gave it away? So, yeah. Oh, and Brandon Rogers, don't leave because there is something I'm going to bring up in a bit. Lady Steele, what's up? Jerry. I think I said hello already. How's it going? So there you have it, man. Terry Bradshaw had to get it. Of course, he was the best 2 quarterbacks in Steeler history. Of course, are Big Ben and Bradshaw. So I got the TV still on. I was watching an old race. Now it's playing some other old race now. But yeah, I already put the volume off and everything. But what's up, everybody? How's it going on this random Monday night? So anybody wanna? I don't know. I was thinking about dropping a link, but then again, I don't know, man. What we got popping tonight, man? Steeler Nation, how we feeling? After this whole draft has concluded, how we feeling about our draft picks? How's everyone else feeling about the draft? I know some people aren't happy about it. Some people are excited. So, I mean, what we got going on, man? What we got going on here, man? Man, I'm just glad I finally get this jersey right here. This Terry Bradshaw jersey. Not only that, man, and I end up with free pirate gear because of them fucking up. I end up with basically free Pittsburgh Pirates gear, which I'm whatever with. But I'll be honest, that logo on the shirt that I got is fire. It's nice. I'll probably be wearing that motherfucker with pride. Now, that's a nice logo, though. I guess that's some vintage shit. That's an old logo from back in the day, I believe. So there you have it, man. I don't know. Should I drop the link or no? Oh. Oh, I didn't even realize this. So I guess when you go live on both channels, you end up popping the link on both of them. Oh, look, see? There's my back. There's my backup right there. Uh-oh. And then there's this one. And then there's... Uh-oh. And then there's that one. Cool. Well, he played... Well, he's from your state. He's from your state, but he played on my team. He played on my team, though, from 1970 through 1983. Of course, his last play was a touchdown pass. Through, I believe, to Calvin Sweeney, I believe, was the touchdown pass. And he ended up popping something in his arm. And that ended his career right there. He basically was like, yeah, I'm done. This is like, I believe this is towards the end of the 83 season. I mean, a lot of our key players from the 70s were retired. Some of them were gone. He was still playing. We made the mistake of keeping him too long, of course. That year is known for us passing up on Dan Marino to draft a guy who only lasted 6 games with us until he got paralyzed, until he got fucking paralyzed and shit. Oh, what's up, Chad? And man, it was his last play was in a regular season game back in 83. And it was a touchdown pass in the second quarter to Calvin Sweeney. He threw it, he felt something pop, and that was it. He basically walked off the field and basically said he's done. He's not doing that anymore. So that's back 2 years in a way, man. You know, passing up on Dan Marino because Bradshaw thought he could still do it. Then that same year, he decides to call it quits because of the injury to his arm. And yeah, it set us back. Had to deal with fucking bums like Bobby Brister, Neil O'Donnell, Cordell Stewart, Tommy Maddox, and all them motherfuckers, man. It's tough, man. And what could have been had we not passed up on Dan Marino? You know, maybe kept Bradshaw for a year or two, but Jeff Marino, and then he could... Maybe he would have been starting by the very next year, and who knows what could have been for us, man. Instead of having to deal with these bum-ass quarterbacks. I ain't drinking Pacifico, man. I ain't drinking Pacifico. Wait, are you commenting my backup page or on my... Are you commenting my backup page or on my main channel? Because I can see your comment here, but I can't see it over there. Unless you commented that on my backup. Yeah, because I'm live on my main channel. Oops. I'm live on my main channel. I don't know, if y'all come to my backup, I suggest you come over to my main page. That's where I'm doing this live stream. Oh, you did comment on my backup, man. You did comment on my backup page. Just saying, you know, bro, I'm live on my main channel. Oh. Motown Pride in the house. And he already got timed out by Dashy. And it looks like Dashy already timed him out. Man, y'all motherfuckers need a one-on-one, man. Y'all need to battle. Y'all need to fucking battle one-on-one. Need to battle one-on-one. Oh, are we really starting with this again? Nah, we ain't doing this. Man, what is with this fucking weird ass shit, man, with necrophilia and incest, man? That's some weird ass motherfuckers, man. Y'all are fucking weird. Think so. He tells Johnston, thank you for beating the dolls. And Dashy times him out again. And Dashy times him out again. Yeah, I know. I just said it. I keep seeing it. Yeah, those guys need a one-on-one. What they need is to both hop on the panel and battle it out one-on-one. That's what they need. That's what they fucking need. Yeah, speaking of that, man, I did see that you and Brandon were battling in Yinz's backup channel. I saw that. I was lurking in there. Yeah, I saw that you were battling, that you and Brandon Rogers are kind of going at it in a Yinz stream. It was on his backup channel, and I was lurking in there. I was in there lurking. I watched that. I was in that motherfucker lurking. One second. Yeah, I don't need to hear it. I know you guys will never like each other, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, I get it. You don't need to constantly bring it up, like, because the thing is you keep talking about it. That shit gets annoying. We get it. You don't have to say it 50,000 fucking times, man. We get it. You guys don't like each other. We get it. And damn, you fucking trolls, man. Look at this. Look at that. Oh, here we go. Yeah, that's real nice, huh? Racist ass shit, huh? How come I don't see the comment here? Scottzilla in the house. Let me go to my backup. Hold on. Let me give it 300 real quick. Looks like it commented that on my backup. There we go. Not having it. Not having it with the racist ass shit, man. Oh my god, y'all are weird. How can you like... Yeah, it looks like I'll be giving 300s here. Chad baked and pie-eyed. What do you mean? No, it's a 7 on here. It's a 7 on here, but unless people are watching my on my backup channel. Jeez, I figured I'd go live on both channels. Obviously, the main one is the one where I'm going to have all the audience at, of course. And the back... And that shit times out, Motown Pride again. Yeah. I'm live here and on my Ghost of Ernie Stotner channel. And obviously my backup is being invaded by this necrophilia shit, man. Hold on. Hold on a second. Let me just go to my backup. Obviously, there's a lot of trolls on my backup channel. Let me just hide that real quick. There's 3 people watching from my backup, and there's 5 watching on here. Interesting. I probably should have just went live on one channel, but... Wait, what? I don't know what you're talking about. Scottzilla in the house. Of course, here's my Bradshaw jersey. No Ernie Stotner today. Obviously, that Ernie Stotner jersey that y'all love so much is hanging over there, and it's going to stay up there. I do like my Terry Bradshaw jersey, though. Hold on a second. Oh my god. Oh look, another troll account. Oh my. Yeah. That all started That necrophilia stuff all started at Masha's streams. It's been happening at Mike Masha's streams. It's been happening at JP's, I believe. I think A-Bomb. I think A-Bombs, maybe. I think Camel. I know Camel Tools be having trolls like that in his streams, too. Man, I feel like it's the same individual doing this shit. Some weird ass motherfuckers, man. It's not a Rogers jersey. It's a Bradshaw. Can't you see it's Terry Bradshaw? See that it's black? The 12 on it? It's Terry Bradshaw, man. Why don't you go there? Why don't you go into the moss streams, man? Those can get lit at times. Those can get fucking lit at times, man. Why can't I click on it? Wait, who's your team? Martindale 416. Who's your team? Why, are you a Bears fan or something? Yeah, it kind of looks like a Packers jersey now you look at it. Yeesh. Nah. Kind of does look like a Packers jersey a little bit, especially with that the 12 is a block number, but obviously it's an old school Steelers jersey with Bradshaw's name on it. Fucking Christ, man. You notice how the trolls are commenting on my backup now? They're fucking be leaving comments on my backup channel. I mean, I can't see them there because it's on my backup, but I could still block them and time them out and give them 300s and shit. There you go. Oh, look, Dashy finally comments. I was lurking, trying to play mind games with the fool. Yeah, of course. Yeah. It wouldn't be an Erica Steele stream. It wouldn't be an Erica Steele stream if it doesn't buffer and shit. Fuck, this internet can suck sometimes, man. This internet can suck sometimes. Hate it when it does that, man. What was I gonna say? Shit, I was gonna bring something up. So I hear word that I guess do you guys know the VidMaker, Branton Philly fan, RPF as people call him? I don't know, you guys know this one VidMaker named RPF, Ranting Philly Fan. I don't know if you guys know who he is, but he's an Eagles VidMaker. He's controversial, to say the least. I was always cool with him. I mean, me and him always got along well and all that. But I know a lot of people didn't like him with because of how he is and all that. I think it could be entertaining, even though I don't agree with some shit he would say, but I was cool with him. But the word is, I don't know if it's true or not, or if it's fake, but I guess words roaming around that he passed away. That's what I've been hearing. I got a receipt here, a comment, a screenshot here that I can read y'all and I could show you guys. I ain't bullshitting or anything, so that's what I hear. I hear that he passed away. That he died. I don't know if it's true or not. Hold on, let me show you guys real quick. I got it. Look, see? Hold on, let me remove that fucking comment. Oh, there you go. Look. See? Renting feels brain hemorrhage. I want to know if that's true or not, man. I'd rather see the guy alive, but it ain't cool to joke around about that shit, though. So I guess the word is he passed away. I don't know. He was entertained, but at the same time, he did threaten people. Like, I'm not gonna lie. I don't know his name, bro. I don't know his name. I mean, I don't know his government name or anything, nor do I care. Well, I think he had a Twitter. Let me see if he had a Twitter. Okay, so he does have a Twitter. Hold on. Unknown. I could type it in the private chat, unknown, so I can give you the Twitter name. I think you may be able to get a clue or whatever. You may be able to get a clue on who he is or whatever. I'm not giving out government names or anything. Wait, what? Yeah, I saw it. They were protesting at Old Trafford. I think those fans are idiots. I think they're butthurt little bitches. I don't know. Don't care. Man Union's an overrated ass fucking team. They are of the past. They ain't gonna win shit so anymore. And yes, Champions League semifinals, my team, Chelsea, of course, plays on Wednesday against Real Madrid. Man City goes tomorrow against PSG. Of course, they have a 2-1 lead heading home to their stadium. Oh, there is a documentary about RPF. And he used a lot of pills. Damn, that ain't good, but... So, do you think he's really dead? So, do you think he's actually dead, though, then? Hold on, let's look up something here. For those of you that do not know who he is, let's look it up here. This is the guy I'm talking about. He had a bunch of channels removed and shit. He had like a bunch of channels. Ranting Philly fan R-rated. Let's see, that's 2 years ago. Damn, he had a bunch of channels, huh? Ranty Sleepy Philly Fan L Room. That was 3 years ago. Damn, he had a bunch of channels. I know he has some channels removed and shit, so. Hold on. Let's see here.
Fuck, it's the matter with some people. You know, I am really pissed off right now at Darius and Desert Eagle. Desert Eagle, yo, motherfucker. You're picking up on the fuck, and I like your ass. What the fuck you doing picking up the hype train of Darius, huh? Why are you motherfucking millennials, you fucking 20-year-olds, basing everything you fucking see on Twitter? Who cares about Twitter? Does that fucking mean that every Eagle fan in the Philadelphia area doesn't deserve a Super Bowl? That every Eagle fan who lives in the Philadelphia area, or everybody that died on Eagle fan doesn't deserve to win a Super Bowl, doesn't deserve that Nick Foles quarterback? Yo, motherfucker, I've been an Eagle fan long and you've been fucking alive, okay? I've been Eagle fan since the fucking late 80s, okay? I waited 30 years for fucking Super Bowl. I like Nick Foles, and I always liked Nick Foles, and I didn't bash him last night. Most of us real Eagle fans did. And you motherfuckers gonna base everything on Twitter? Who cares what Twitter says or Facebook? They're gonna base every Eagle fan on earth and call every Eagle fan losers and say Eagle fans as a whole don't deserve the fucking championship. Now fuck that. You guys are way out of bounds. You guys are way wrong. It's bullshit. You should have said your fucking videos and your fucking titles. You should have fucking said, hey guys, the best of what? The people on Twitter, the Eagles fans on Twitter, they don't deserve a Super Bowl. You should have said that, but you didn't. You didn't put down your fucking title. You generalized and said everybody fucking deserves a fucking, doesn't deserve a Super Bowl. I've been a fucking fan for 30 years, Desert. Woman, you've been fucking alive. You were born in 1990, motherfucker. I was an Eagles fan in 1988. I waited 30 goddamn years for a fucking Super Bowl title. And I'm still happy the Eagles won it. And I'm still happy Nick Foles is here. And I'm not advocating Nick Foles ever be traded.
Hold on. Here's more. Look at that. Another channel right here. Yeah, I know he had like a bunch of channels taken down and shit. You know, the thing is, I was in this guy's, I was actually in this guy's stream not that long ago. Oh, look, streamed 3 weeks ago. I was actually over there just to say what's up. And now he's possibly dead. I don't know if it's true or not, but let me click on. Oops. Oh, I'm actually click that link that unknown put out. It's gonna have to click on my own stream. damn, it's an hour and 47 minutes. Yeah. Yeah, I'm not going to waste time. I'm not going to spend it all watching it now. So, turn your camera on real quick to see it. If that's you, if not, then get the fuck out. Turn your camera on for 1 second, and then you can turn it back off. Just turn it off for once. Oh, wait. Oh, okay.
There we go.
I want to make sure.
I did it earlier, and I accidentally got it on there by mistake. I'm like, oh, the little things down there. I don't think. Could you at least go full screen just until I get it on there? Thanks. Ah, oh, come on.
Do you know about this ranting Philly fan guy?
I've heard of him. I just haven't watched him very often.
Because someone said he's dead.
Yeah, I saw.
I don't know.
We're going to do this again. Switching back and forth between Mets and Cardinals and the Sixer game. Sixers were up by 20. It's now only up, now it's us by only 5 with 5 minutes to go. That's a good block. And the Cardinals pitcher's throwing wild. All they need is one out.
Why don't we talk about how shitty your draft was from what I heard?
We started out pretty well. Devontae Smith. And then it could have gone better. But there's a, you know, it's not how do I word this? Some picks turn out to be better than you expect. I mean, high picks turn out to be some high picks turn out to be bad. Some low picks turn out to be good. You never know. This draft class may come back to surprise you. Another walk. Come on. One out and we're back in first. I'm going to be real used to troll.
Dash your camera on real quick.
Here comes Dash Man. Da 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 Dash Man.
Okay. What you got to say to Motown Pride?
I'm deciding to ignore
that.
I decided to ignore that fool. But I have. But in case you didn't see the video.
Yeah.
Look what he has here. Look at the profile picture. He's a Lions and a Giants fan.
Motown claims it was part of a quote unquote troll job.
That's a failure troll job. I know Tyson, aka Master Edward, can do the better troll.
Was he trying to change his name to try and look like somebody else?
No.
Kind of like Bengalator did James Littleton?
No, that was a failed troll job.
For crying out loud. It's 6-5 St. Louis, but the Mets have 2-1 with 2 out. Dominic Smith coming up. Come on, one is all you need. This is like how the Phillies ended. Couldn't get one out to save their life. We did win, thankfully. Oh, now my thing wants to freeze.
Come in and talk about unknown. Used to troll RPF. Come in, tap the link.
Here it goes.
Yeah, I'm playing mind games with this fool tonight. Whenever I see him, time him back out. He doesn't know I was lurking in there and on here.
Wide open! Come on! And a foul! Oh my gosh. We really just let him right back. Come on, we were up as many as 20. And you let him all the way back. We need this to gain on the Nets. Come on. Let's keep our foot on the Nets' throat.
We need this to keep up with the Wizards.
Battle
this is
of
a must
powers.
Win game for us.
It's a must win game if we want to have the number one. Have the
turn your
number
camera
one
on real
seed.
Quick. Turn your camera on real quick to make sure it's you. Okay.
Come on, Seth. Do something with it. Toby. Unknown in the building.
Yo, what's up?
Almost lost it. 4 seconds. Come on, do.
Yo, what's up? You used Tell us about us trolling RPF.
So, I'm gonna have to tell you how it all went. So one time I was like a freshman, and I was like a troll, dude. I had like some troll accounts, and I used a troll account called RPF is a faggot, and I commented saying, "Yo, RPF, bro, like, you seriously think you're gonna do all this shit, but you freeze up like a bitch in public, dude."
All right, cause he did threaten people, though. I ain't gonna lie, he did. He would threaten people. I mean, he was cool with me and all. I didn't have a problem with him, but I know some people did, though. I know some people did have a problem with him.
I told you we were going to get some old linemen in the second round. I wasn't kidding when I said it.
Well, did you? I don't really pay attention to see what the Bengals.
We did. Jackson Carmen, the Cincinnati native from Clemson.
Well, we did too. And we also, and the tight end we drafted is from my home state. So y'all can call me crazy, but I'm getting this jersey.
Well, I'm planning on getting a new Bengals new stripes jersey. And I only got vaccinated once.
Yeah, I'm planning to get a Devontae Smith shirt soon. Popped up. Left field. Ball game. Hey. We are first place ball team again. Cardinals.
Fuck you, Cardinals. Fuck you, Cardinals. I want you to lose that game.
Fuck the Cowboys.
Yes, thank you.
Fucking hate their fucking toxic ass fans, dude.
Oh, they get annoying. I mean, some of them
I hate the St. Louis bitchinos. If we got the fucking Chicago White Sox next, at least I get to say this about the White Sox. We at least beat them in a World Series.
Yeah. But yeah.
Then would you rather wear a Michigan jersey or a Cardinals jersey?
Oh!
Neither.
If you had to pick one.
Neither.
If you have to pick one to save your life.
Yeah.
I wouldn't wear neither one of those. I hate those.
Here's a better one. Would you rather wear a Browns jersey or a Michigan jersey?
Oh.
Neither.
Who do you hate more?
In the MLB, I hate the Cardinals, obviously. In the NFL, I hate the Browns. College, I hate Michigan. In the NHL, obviously, I hate the Kings. In the NBA, obviously, four of my division rivals in the Central Division are tied for my most hated team because I'm a Bulls fan.
Yes, Toby.
Do you also hate the Red Wings, though?
I hate the Red Wings, too.
I don't really hate them now.
Because the old Ducks-Red Wings rivalry back in the Western Conference?
Oh, how's that a foul?
So are you still mad about the 2013 playoff series?
3-1.
I'm pretty much over.
And then it's funny because the Red Wings would blow a 3-1 lead themselves the following round.
Oh, backstage dressers bring it up.
You are up 3-2. We couldn't do shit with it. And we went 3-2 on a certain team that Eric hates in the Western Conference Finals in 2015, and we blew that.
Well,
that's another reason.
Blackhawks.
Exactly. I hate Bruce Brashio for that. Fuck you, Bruce Brashio. I'm glad you're gone out of Anaheim, you piece of shit.
The former 76er, Thaddeus Young to the line.
What's an athlete you guys hate?
Ooh, I gotta think about it.
Wait, what did you say?
What's a player?
What's a player that you guys that we hate? Ronald Acuna Jr.
Yadier Molina.
LeBron James.
LeBron James.
Whoever's backstage, turn your camera on real quick. Whoever is backstage.
Tom Brady.
Turn your camera on real quick.
I always hated Patrick Lundqvist when he was with the Rangers.
Oh, okay.
Ben Simmons actually made a free throw for one.
Terry Bradshaw.
Was that Brandon Rogers I just saw?
Maybe.
Yes, that's him. Hey, Brandon, tell us about, is it true that RPF's dead?
That's what I heard.
Yeah, same. I remember I used to go on his live streams and troll him.
Dude, he threatened me so many times. I can't even count it how many. Like, oh my God, it got unreal.
Like, why would he threaten you on? Because I think I did a live stream one time and I had him on and you were commenting. You were trolling him in the comments, and I guess it was.
You punk,
I remember
kid.
He was going off on you.
You sissy kid. Everybody calls me fat. I don't know. His rants were hilarious, though. Better than Dashy's rants. That's hard to do.
Who would win in the 1-on-1 between Dashy and RPF?
I got RPF. No, because here's the thing. RPF goes at family very quickly. So then once RPF goes at Dashy's family, Dashy's just going to get all triggered and lose. So there you go. Ain't that right, Marge Scott?
Oh! I'll put this out. Brandon, it's pronounced shot.
Oh, shot. Oops. Oh, that was Marge
Scott.
You're
good. You didn't know.
Marge shot. Yeah, Dashy. Yep.
You didn't know.
Hey, Brad, I saw that live. I saw that live stream from last night that I was lurking in. There was some simping going on.
You know what, Eric? Hang on. You want to show jerseys? All right, I got you. Let's get it going.
Planning to get a Devontae soon. Speaking of jersey, ooh,
Mike. Yeah, Jamal Adams.
Jamal Adams.
That's just for you.
33. Like former Hokie Cam Chancellor. Wait, no. Cam Chancellor was 31, wasn't he?
Yo, hey, Brandon,
I'm surprised.
Why do I remember
him
being
33?
Fanatics worked perfectly for me. I don't know what happened.
Well, they fucked up your tongue, but nothing beats this jersey right here.
Do they not like Mexicans, Eric? are they a bit racist?
Maybe. Cool. Maybe they're racist like
I didn't know. I didn't know 412 owned Fanatics.
Yeah. Hey, Brandon, you were in that stream. Tell us about the simping that went on last night.
Wait, Eric, hang on. So when they originally sent you a package, they gave you a Pirates hat?
Yeah.
And a throwback Pirates long sleeve shirt. Holy you know, the crap. One with the old 70s logo on it.
Yeah, and I still have it.
64 seconds and you're
there's
up 9. We should have this. We should have this in the bag. Stolen! Simmons with a little slam. That's likely your game.
What's going on?
Philly Unite's going to win it. Let's go.
Unknown, I see you. I see you over there.
What's going on, Brandon Rogers?
Here it is right here. This is the hat they actually sent me instead of the jersey.
What is that? I'm looking at your new thumbnail. What is that?
They should have sent you a freaking thumbnail.
The one you just had. You switched it.
Oh, that's Trump with Seahawks colors. Unknown gave it to me.
I could tell by looking at his.
Damn, they couldn't have at least gave you a flat bill hat. Shit. Oh, there's the cap.
The caps are better, in my opinion.
I always wear caps like this.
Wait, did you leave the sticker on it? I never leave stickers on my hats. Oh, well, that's fair. It's at least some big old sticker.
Brandon. Brandon.
Shut up, Unknown.
Oh man. Brandon. Unknown keeping it up. Keeping it up is what I said, by the way.
Hey, oh so God, what's up with this?
What is that?
So I don't need to know about the simping that went on last night.
Big booty white bitches.
Are you talking in Masha's stream?
Yeah. I replayed it this morning.
Well, the guy running the stream is a simp. So, yeah, obviously there's going to be simping. Oh, he just called Mosh a simp.
Dude, I can't go to Mosh.
Wow.
I can't take Mosh seriously, dude. He just simps every night.
I can't go through this fucking stream.
There's backstage in every 5 minutes.
Oh, yeah, he always throws people backstage. So when I say I'm going to pull a Mosh, that means I'm going to backstage you.
All right. I'll see you backstage, Eric. Mosh will somehow get his hands on this stream yard and he'll backstage us. So I'll see you backstage. Yeah, she stopped looking all stupid. What she got?
Brandon, I'm just going to dribble it out. Let's go.
Ashley, I have to go to work tomorrow, so
everything went perfectly.
Actually, I gotta get some sleep, so well, I catch you guys later.
How'd I know?
106-94 final. We win. All right,
who's
Terry Bradshaw?
Turn your camera on to the person backstage real quick. Okay, you can turn it back off now.
Eddie!
What's up?
Eddie? What's going on, Eddie? Good to see you.
Good to see you. Yeah, I guess Eric's just trying to make sure I'm not a troll.
Yeah.
Yeah, and JP, I ain't letting anyone in here.
Dude, JP's fucking weird, my dude.
Definitely.
You need to stop allowing certain people in this fucking panel.
Yeah, I feel he just lets 412. Anybody in.
412.
Hey, he does, at least he needs to ask them to turn their camera on real quick and then let him in.
Terry Bradshaw?
Terry Bradshaw.
So,
and what
so
is it?
Are you going to create a backup channel somebody for the ghost seeing? Is it now the ghost of Terry Bradshaw or is it Ernie Stotner?
Nope. Ernie Stotner. Nothing beats that.
Obsession.
Terry Bradshaw's still alive. Terry Bradshaw's still alive.
But you're playing the character of Terry Bradshaw tonight.
Boom.
There you go. I see. Terry Bradshaw in the name. Hey, that's my name too. Oh, we're both Terry too.
Yo, Brandon, do you put makeup on your lips?
Oh,
what?
I did promote a little something on Instagram yesterday, though. Ernie Stotner runs on Dunkin's.
Oh yeah, God. I saw that.
Ernie Stotner runs on Dunkin', motherfuckers.
Brandon.
I was gonna say like.
No, go ahead, Eddie.
And I know you still call out what is it real shit 412 about like he doesn't even know the last two jerseys.
I forget who's hang out one night. Stalking somebody.
He stalks everybody. Stalking
somebody. No, everybody shout Sam! Sam! Stalking this one girl.
He was simping on. What's her phrase? Last night he was simping on Dantel.
Oh my gosh.
The veterinary?
Yeah, I don't
it's
know
just
why.
Eagles fan.
I don't know why.
Yeah, he was simping on that. He was simping on that Oprah Winfrey shit, dude.
He likes the fat puss. That's what he likes. He likes the fat puss. He likes
She used to go by the name of Philly fan always Dantel.
Rings a bell.
Yeah, she's an Eagles fan like you. And yeah, he was in there simping for.
Oh, yeah, I forgot Johnster's an Eagles fan. Oh shit, yeah, not many of you on here. Big props to you. Do you watch? Do you watch Champs Birds?
I have to look that one up.
I remember Desert Eagle was clowning him because of Le'Veon Bell. Because of the Le'Veon Bell shit?
No, dude, I remember Joey Shakes and RPF would go at fucking Champs Birds.
Yeah, and he made a video one time, dude.
Dude, Joey Shakes is goated. That guy's great.
Yeah, because you know how, like, I thought
he... Lord Brunson has pretty much become the new face of the fan base.
Lord Brunson, that's a name I haven't heard in a while.
Yeah, it was like, I thought everybody in the Eagles, on the Eagles fan base, like, hates Champ Birds.
No, he just rambles on stupid shit.
You can't hate him if you haven't seen him.
Doesn't he threaten people as well?
No, he threatened me.
I don't know because I've never seen him.
Him and RPF just threatened each other. It was hilarious.
Yeah. I'll never forget to hang out. Like, he called out Jake one time.
Oh, Jake Reynolds? Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Whatever happened to Jake Reynolds, dude? I hadn't heard about that dude in a while.
He's in the foreign stock exchange now.
Damn.
He's doing Forex.
Yeah, it's like
a rich boy.
He's not making videos anymore.
Yeah, and I would have just stuck with that, especially since his channel was monetized and everything.
Uh-huh.
It's okay, Terry Bradshaw. You'll get there.
Are
you monetized?
I'm not even at 1,000 subs, so nor do I care.
Shit. Oh, damn.
I don't care. I'm not here to leech off of people, so it is what it is.
I mean, it's nice to make a quick buck or two coming on YouTube. It is. I can't lie, but, you know, that's not what we're here to do.
Yeah, I'm not going to beg for money like other people do.
Mike Mosh.
And another certain somebody, like, and this is how he paid. That's how he paid for all his Eagle games.
Now, I thought you were going to talk about Slitta.
Well, not him. No.
Well, he does beg for money, though. That's a fact.
Does he?
It's okay, Eric. You both couldn't have the same girl. It's okay, but he paid.
Oh,
yeah. Fuck you, man.
No.
Hey, no, Brandon, dude. I didn't give away my hard-earned money like he did.
I was talking about EDP. Like, he begged for money just how he goes to the Eagles games.
I don't know if EDP begged for that money. I wouldn't say he begged for it. EDP's just, yeah. Well, he was entertaining. Now he's just a fucking weirdo.
He's a pedophile.
Yeah.
He did have his moments. If unfortunately they went the wayside.
Oh, I'll never forget when they lost to the Vikings or whatever. He wiped that Eagles jersey with his
hat. Oh yeah.
Use the Eagles jersey as toilet paper.
The one vid that Eric showed the other night, the James White play with the Celine Dion playing. It was hilarious.
Whoa, Eric.
I remember being in that hangout.
Yeah.
Eric.
Those videos were fun.
Throwing everything.
Eric, you have to change your profile picture to Terry Bradshaw. Or your old thumbnail. Change that to fucking Terry. Come on. Where's Terry? It's not Ernie tonight. It's Terry. You can go back to Ernie tomorrow.
Sorry, did I miss another? Sounds like I missed another battle of you and Dashy going at it.
That wasn't even a battle. I just freaking mocked him and then he left.
Nah, but I saw you and Nosferatu battle a bit in Yinz's stream. I was lurking
Fuck
in
that,
there.
Idiot.
I Fuck was in Yinz. There lurking.
Yinz is an idiot and so is that little faggot Jordan.
I like the way Yinz talks.
Whoa. And Dash just timed out Motown Pride.
What a faggot. I knew he was lurking.
I have to go to work in the morning, but I'm still here.
Yo, Brandon.
Shut up, milkmaid.
Yo, Brandon. Dude, I know you would hit fucking PCG, dude.
Dude, what the fuck? No.
Oh, five-head.
Hey, it's your girl.
that's Eric's girl.
That five-head? Nah, that's supposed to be Slitter's girl. Slitter sent her the money, $300.
Wow, where was I?
What an idiot. I can't imagine sending someone on the internet $300. I guess you could ask Nuzdar or Slitter how it feels.
Nuzdar simps for men, dude.
Unless, of course, you're like ordering something online. That's technically giving somebody
that's money right there. That's more of a, well, yeah, I guess technically, because you either be getting book company.
Yeah. So, Eric, what did you do with that stuff that Fanatic sent you by accident?
Oh, he kept it.
I still have. Oh, I kept it. Look, this is the hat.
The president didn't give me anything NASCAR.
I wouldn't much rather have that, except
it'd be perfect for him.
Do they sell NASCAR gear?
On Fanatics, yes. Yeah, I follow, but yeah.
Oh. Who won the race? Kyle Busch, was it? Yeah.
Yeah.
Because you thought you, that was like back mainstream. You were showing that off.
Who's your favorite driver now, Eric?
Alex Bowman. Yeah, he sucks. So he had that one race win, but then he did bad in the other ones. He wasn't even competitive.
What car is he riding in? Is he in the 48?
Yeah.
Oh, he took over for Jimmy. Okay.
Yeah, the 88 car that he was driving, Kyle Larson's in that now, and they changed the number.
Oh, the racist?
Yeah, they changed the number from 88 to 5.
Dude. Unknown. Get that fucking queer off the screen. Nobody cares about Billie Eilish. She's an idiot.
I know, but I mean, her body.
I think he's trying to troll. Unknown did admit to being a big time troll. Just pointing that out.
That's what he's here to do. Look at his name. He's definitely here to troll. Who the fuck is who has the name Barnacle Balls? That's when you know he's trolling.
Oh, shoot. Photograph.
Well, you did say you used to troll the fuck out of RPF.
Yeah. I think everybody did at some point.
Yeah, and I'm going to be real. I used to troll Desert Eagle, like, not a lot, but, like, there was times where I used Quavo's, like, pictures, and I put Desert Eagle's cousin.
Like, oh my gosh. No, dude, apparently Duke Bothers met up with Trucker Tim.
When was this?
Like tonight.
Oh shit, how did I miss that?
Well, you're probably out getting Dunkin's.
Oh!
Do you ever get a donut from there, or do you just get coffee? Like, Jesus Christ.
I mainly get coffee. I get donut here and there. And Dash just timed out Motown Pride again.
You know what? On my dash, let me go time his ass out.
I go to Starbucks.
See, now you're just trolling, Eric.
Dunkin' has good donuts.
I mean, it's
in the name.
you know you can't win because I keep fact checking you. You knew I was lurking. You lose again.
It reminds me of that
one scene. What's it from? It's like, you get nothing, you lose.
Oh, good Willy Wonka time. The Chocolate Factory.
Is it Willy Wonka,
dude?
Yep.
How does Motown Pride lose if he knew that you were lurking, Dashy? Doesn't that mean he wins?
Basically, come on. Think.
Yeah, it does.
I wet my back.
Dash, you always lose. Shut your ass up.
I probably should have went out of my back up there. Dash, you wouldn't be able to time him out.
Let me go time Dash you out. Fuck that cunt.
Fuck that cunt.
Wow, that is dirty right there.
Okay, you can do it. Do it real quick.
Yeah, but I was like,
oh,
man,
timed them out.
I hope one day we get Dunkin' Donuts back over in Washington.
Oh yeah,
you don't have Dunkin's out there.
We used to.
What happened?
I think it was in 2000, like probably think 2002, 2003. Like they all closed. The closest ones I have to go to is like in California, or. Maybe the southern part of Oregon.
Wait, where are you from, dude?
Who?
You.
Yeah, I'm in Washington State.
Ooh.
Yeah, yeah, I'm about 40 minutes. Yeah, I'm about 40 minutes from Seattle.
Yeah, Eagle Speed lives in Washington State, dude.
I think that Corey Simp also lives out there, too.
Yeah, he does. I think in Spokane or something.
Oh, yeah, Spokane. Yeah, I'm about like 4 or 5 hours away from there.
I'm in Vegas.
I'm in Massachusetts.
Yeah, I hope to go to Vegas next year for the draft.
For real?
But I know like a lot of the hotels out there are booked right now.
Book a Trump hotel.
Yeah. Oh, I mean, what if I got family out there, so I could? I don't need to book no hotel.
Oh shit! Nice.
I got family out in Vegas too.
For real?
Yeah. Oh yeah. So I guess when you, Eric, when you go to Vegas, you don't need to book a hotel.
Hell no! I got a place to stay at.
Yo, Eric, have you ever been to Florida?
Nah.
I don't know, but I'm fighting with myself either going to a Packers game this year or going to Florida.
Go to the game. Don't be a TV fan. Go to a game.
I know.
Yeah, I guess for us, like,
go to a game. Go to a game.
I'm praying when the schedule comes out. It's like, I'm like begging, please don't have us have the Seahawks go to Lambeau in December.
Shit, I hope
you should play them either really early or toward the end.
Huh?
It's hard to win in that stadium when it's cold.
Seahawks Packers, when it's on the schedule, usually happens either one of the first couple weeks of the season or it's really late, like in mid December.
I'll Seattle and Green Bay play in December.
Yeah. We'll find out a week from Wednesday. We'll find out.
Yeah, so what's going on with your boy Aaron Rodgers?
Shit, dude. I mean, fucking from garbage ass fucking news articles saying Aaron Rodgers wants Brian Gutekunst fired to, I don't know, dude. I mean, he might stay for another year. Who knows at this point?
Yeah, because we all saw the breaking news saying he doesn't want to be there anymore.
And it was official. I feel bad for him, to be real with you.
Oh, yeah. I think
what's to say? The score, Motown Pride, 900,000-0. Had to count the zeros there for a second. Even Tevin could beat that shit in a battle of the brains. that is a good diss though, Motown Pride. That is a good diss. And all of a sudden I got quiet. There we go.
Yeah, I was gonna say like, because I know you guys don't want to have to start Jordan Love.
Look, I just wanted another year with Rodgers. If Rodgers does this shit again, or if, I don't know, gets injured unexpectedly, I want to see Jordan Love playing Green Bay. Either way, dude.
Oh, yeah. Because I say watch out for all the Bears fans because they've been smack-talking you all through the draft.
They've been doing that shit, dude, but what have they been doing for the past decades and shit?
Yeah. And even I have an uncle who's a Bears fan, and I keep saying, man, talk to us when you get a real quarterback. Because Bears have been known for having trash quarterbacks.
I mean, either way, I mean, Justin Fields
could buck the trend. He has the capability of bucking that trend if Matt Nagy actually starts him. That's going to be pretty awkward. They put that QB1 with Dalton, and now they're probably going to start Justin Fields.
Hold up. Yeah, hold up. Dalton's going to start. Then if something doesn't go the Bears' way, then Fields is going to start. It's fucking stupid. Dude, fuck Justin Fields.
The Bears are a mess. They have been since 85, 86.
Not to mention the kid. Okay, during the draft, it was down to either Justin Fields or Mac Jones. Because it's like, because people said if the Bears would have got Mac Jones, they probably would have been a bigger laughing stock. But hey, and also, hey, Johnster, I like that Devontae Smith pick you guys got.
Tell me about it. I'm excited.
Yeah. It's like, man, the Cowboys could have had that guy.
I know. We traded up to get past the Giants, and we got him.
Dang.
I mean, I know, like, for us, it's like, I mean, I knew we weren't going to have a lot of picks, especially after what we gave up for Jamal Adams.
Yeah.
Well, I have a statement to make about the EDP situation. So,
right, go ahead.
I saw like a video, a Facebook page. I don't know if it's official. I feel like it's actually new and real. I don't know, dude. Why isn't he in jail yet?
The poacher, whoever's botched that situation, that's why.
I mean, fuck, dude. I mean, predator poachers. I mean, I look. Yeah, said the N-word and all that. Guy always fucks around like that and shit. But I mean, they let him walk free.
Well, it looks like in the video, like they were trying to chase after him, and like, you know how like they go around and like get the car. The license plates of the car and try and report it to the police.
Yeah, they didn't do it.
Why weren't they in contact with him before they did that video? That's the thing.
It's fucking stupid.
It's like, man. Yeah, because I always thought, like, right now, like, EDP's probably sitting there, like, probably, like, hiding at, like, maybe his sister's house.
He's making a website, I heard.
Nah, if that was my brother, I wouldn't allow him in my fucking house, dude, at all.
Or he's just trying to lay low.
Nah, but I would say, dude, you gotta turn yourself in, dude.
Yeah, it's the right thing to do.
Yeah, exactly.
There's a couple people that think this is might happen if he goes in jail. Because some think he's going to commit suicide.
I don't think he's going to jail at all, to be honest.
Yeah. And, I mean, like I keep saying, he should have learned his lesson the first time. Instead of, like, being stupid and driving to Las Vegas and trying to meet up with a 13-year-old.
Bakersfield.
I thought he took the road trip to Vegas.
Nope. I've been all around Vegas. That's not in Vegas. That's in Bakersfield.
Oh, yeah. And that's all what. Yeah, because when I said Vegas, I'm like, wait. When you're a minor, there's nothing for you to do in Las Vegas.
And I'm 18. I mean, there is something to do in Vegas, dude. I mean, you just got to look in deeper. You could go to malls, walk on strip, take pictures with strippers.
Yeah, I know. There's an adventure dome down there.
Yeah, dude, I work there. I work at, it's called Circus. I work there.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I used to go out there a lot as a kid.
Yeah, for real. Yeah, because I've been there the last two times I've been in Vegas.
Shit.
Yeah, but the best part was, like, both times going, it's like, you know, like I never had to pay for the bracelets. Well, if I'm with my family, I never really have to pay for anything. And I know, like, oh yeah, I always forget, like, if you're under 21, you could have your birthday party there too.
Oh look, we got a faggot that's trying to dox people again.
Where? In the other one?
Where is it?
No.
Where? Cause I only see Martindale Motown Pride in there.
No, not Dar.
Oh, Nuzdar again?
Oh hell nah. Dude, I want to see this motherfucker come on the panel, dude.
He's literally live right now on his own. He's putting up Spider-27's government name.
Okay, this faggot's not even built for the TTC, dude.
The only thing I used to know him is like the guy that make that nasty cereal.
Yeah, me too. I mean, I found it entertaining. I mean, you would have stuck to like being that type of, because he was entertaining, I'm not gonna lie, but like over the time he was just so cringy and so fucking obnoxious and stupid as fuck, dude.
Because I looking at all the cereal videos he'd make, it's like, I'm like, how is he not in the hospital? He put after like what he's loading on it.
I mean, he's a dude. He's just a fucking pathetic loser, dude.
Yeah.
Look at that. Now he's putting up pictures of Denzel now.
Oh, no.
I think it was about a month ago. It was like in JP stream. Like, he was trying to take a lot of people to the courthouse.
Dude, I have video of him fucking threatening somebody's children, man. I could, like, seriously, go and report that shit to Nashville authorities. What a fucking loser.
And he was wearing a Seahawks jersey, too. It's like, I thought this guy was a Saints fan.
And I don't want to diss Raider Cousin. I don't got nothing against Raider Cousin. I mean, I'm just neutral, to be real with you, but I mean, the guy said Nuzdar ran me off. Nuzdar never ran me off. I took a break. I've always done this shit since 2016. Ever since I've come to know about this community.
Yeah.
We're circle.
Whatever you want to call it.
Yep. Like, I would even take a year off, and I would come back.
Oh.
He's been going. Look at us. He's like, and he's gone. Brandon knows this. Dashy likes Michigan. He is maize and blue. Dashy is a Pistons fan. He's just been going.
JP just said he can't be cool with Nuzdar anymore, but I don't know.
I'm giving that.
I can't, dude. I just can't, man. I mean, this guy's fucking cringy. This guy acts like, oh, he's less of a racist just because he rocks a fucking Black Lives Matter shirt. And it's fucking stupid because I've seen Meet the Mets share like a screenshot of him wanting to join a panel with the N-word or something. I don't fucking know.
Damn. Did Dash time him out yet?
I think he left.
It's always you may get that one night where you get Dashy at his best.
What they need is a one-on-one battle.
Yeah. Oh yeah, that's right. A few of your streams, like you've had a one-on-one battles with like Dashy and Brandon.
Yeah, I also had a few of those.
I think it was like about a month ago. You almost had you and Real Shit 412 and in your stream, but you kicked him out because you weren't gonna let him over talk you.
Yeah, he overtalks everybody. And Dashi just timed him out again.
Who?
Dashi just timed out Motown Pride.
Oh, he just did? There he goes.
Yeah.
Certain message.
Keep dancing.
Hey, fuck the Bears. And the Lions, excuse me.
Oh, the Lions.
And the Bears, too.
And the Bears. You're a Packer fan. I expect that.
Yeah.
I don't have any hate for the Bears or the Packers or the Lions. I don't have any hate for the Vikings either.
I have a lot of hate against the fucking Cowboys.
I do too.
Me too.
More than the fucking Vikings, the Bears, and the Lions.
I guess the only team we've been owning in your division is the Vikings.
Yeah. Fuck the bad queers.
You've beaten Detroit too, Eddie.
Oh yeah, then the last two times because one of the games I went to. Yeah. Was it 2015? It was like,
can't remember the last time Detroit beat you.
I think it was like Russell Wilson's rookie year in 2012. Oh, yeah, because I looked at... Yeah, I guess that was a heartbreaking loss at the end.
Oh, yeah. Now I remember.
Yeah. I was like, I hope you guys don't have to face them this year.
Detroit?
Yeah.
We do. And it's in Detroit.
Oh, man. I feel bad for you guys.
Why? We played Jared Goff very well.
Oh, okay. It's Matthew Stafford. That's the one.
Stafford was traded. You got to deal with them twice a year.
Oh, yeah. Something tells me the Rams might be a six, seven game win team.
That Ram team is capable of getting back to the postseason.
Hail to Michigan, the champions of the West. Hail to the Victor's Valiant. To the conquering heroes. Hail to Michigan, the champions of the West.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. The only team we have to face in your division is the Washington football team this year.
Yeah. Fail to... It's like Rusty Lake once sang. How did it go? Fail to the football team. Fail miserably. Something like that. I have to see his vid.
They'll always be called the Redskins.
Until they actually get an actual name.
Yeah.
Until they actually get an actual name, which they're hoping to unveil spring or summer of next year. Hopefully it's not something stupid.
Yeah, just like the baseball team, Cleveland Indians, like they're trying to get that. The Indians
are actually doing it right. Are actually changing it correctly. They're not in a rush. They're taking their time so they don't put together some stupid Cleveland baseball club or Cleveland baseball team garbage. Exactly.
It's these fucking and white faggot liberal I'll tell you bitches. What,
to the Indians ownership for changing the name the right way. Dan Snyder could take a lot of pages from their book.
Dude, I don't know why, man. They could have just changed the name at least to Washington Heroes or Washington.
I hear it's probably going to be Washington Red Tails.
Maybe. I don't know, dude.
Red Tails, the last time I looked at the odds board, was indeed the favorite.
The Washington Redskins.
Hang on, let me look at the entire list.
It's fucking stupid. These people want to cancel fucking Bugs, Mexican Bugs Bunny and shit. Like, I give a fuck about.
Okay, bugs from other countries I can understand, like the spotted lantern fly. But Bugs Bunny is pushing it.
It's fucking stupid, man. It's mostly these white females that, well, black men always, all this fucking, the way they fucking talk, the way they move, their movements, all this shit. Fucking annoying, dude. Like, I give a fuck, dude. Like, I've been called a wetback and a beaner. I don't give a shit.
Who's Doug? He just got timed, and Mo Tempura just got timed out by that one this time.
Wait, what? Hold on.
Motown Pride was timed out by Doug for 300 seconds. Not Dashy. Doug. D-O-U-G.
Oh, that's a typer.
How does a typer have a wrench?
Oh, Biden.
Because it's been commenting on my videos since, like, 2016.
Ah, okay. All right, here's your potential Washington new names. Red Tails or Red Clouds, which is currently the favorite. Warriors, Hogs, Red Wolves, Monuments, Presidents, Americans, Federalists, Generals, Guardians, Lincolns, Senators, and Founders. What do we think?
The Red Tails, pretty much.
Yeah, Red Tails right now is the favorite. That's what I'm expecting it to be. Meanwhile, for Cleveland, if this will load.
Mm-hmm.
We have the Cleveland Spiders, Blue Sox, Blues, Rockers or Rocks, Crows, Naps, Buckeyes, Dobies, Fellers, Great Lakes or Lakers, Unions, Cinders, Castles, Hazards, Cuyahogas, Burning Rivers, Rustlers or Bluebirds. 2 cents on those.
Dude, I don't get why people wanna like push politics onto sports, dude.
Some of the stuff that exists back in like the '40s and fifties. Look at Jackie Robinson's day, I'm just gonna say that.
Oh yeah.
Not many people talked about it back then.
All right, guys. It's
how sensitive both sides are now.
I'm ending this.
All right.
Gonna end this. Anyone who wants to catch a replay, go to my backup because I'm privating this.
I need to go. I need to go charge my phone. So, salute, guys.
Yes. So is this the name of your channel?
All right, damn. All right, guys. Later.
All right. Yep.